A very good afternoon to all the participants of the academic fraternity. I, Dr. Shruti Zamsandekar, Assistant Professor at Department of Computer Science, Cyber, welcome you all for the Day 2 Session 3 on Role of ICT and Use of Technology in Teaching and Learning. Our resource person for this session is Dr. Rajni Kamath, ma'am, Associate Professor at Department of Computer Studies, and it's my pleasure to introduce her to you. Dr. Kamath has pursued her bachelor's and master's degree in computer science from Mangalore University. She has received her PhD in computer science, specialized in computer-based visualization from Shivaji University, Kolhapur, and has obtained her master's in business administration from IGNU. Madam has a rich experience of about 16 plus years in teaching and research. She has been teaching courses like business analytics and CA, MSc computer science. And her current specialization is in artificial intelligence and data science. Ma'am has an expertise in ICT-based pedagogy tools such as PowerPoint, Moodle, Google Apps for content creation, content delivery, and assessment. Dr. Kamath has, to her credit, 40 plus research papers published in reputed national and international journals, and has presented more than 15 plus papers in conferences. She is also author of several books on AI, data science, data analytics, as well as has published chapter in Encyclopedia of Information Science and Technology by IGI Global Publishing. Ma'am has completed two minor research projects funded by UGC, as well as one project funded by Maharashtra State Commission for Women. Dr. Kamath is also a recipient of various awards and honors, such as badge by IBM AI Foundation for Educators, Certificate of Excellence by IIT Mumbai among the top performer of the FDP on ICT for Education, Best Paper Award at conference organized at Shivaji University, and has received appreciation by IQAC Cyber on various endeavors. She has been invited as resource person for several conferences, workshops, FDP guest lectures and webinars, and has been serving at various academic and research administration at institute on board of studies panel, as well as different examination panels at the institute as well as at the university level. We welcome you, ma'am, and I request you to take the charge of the session, ma'am.
Thank you very much, Dr. Zamsandekar, for your introduction. At the outset, I thank ITEL Academy, our Institute Cyber, FDP Coordinator, and Team FDP for this invitation. I'm happy to share in this forum that I'm a part of this esteemed Institute Cyber. I'm privileged to discuss ICT-based pedagogy with the delegates present in this online forum. I'll share my presentation. During my presentation, if any technical issues related to presentation or audio, you can inform me. Please unmute and you inform. We can solve it. Just a second. While the whole world is struggling with coronavirus outbreak, business and governments are becoming increasingly reliant on technology to support citizens. For every organization involved in dealing with the crisis, digital systems have become an absolute lifeline. At a time when countries have been placed on lockdown, students are turning to video conferencing apps for getting on with their curriculum as schools remain closed. In this context, I would like to discuss the role of ICT and use of technology in teaching learning that promotes excellence and innovations in teaching learning process. I have planned my presentation in two parts. In the first half, we'll be discussing this topic, and in the second half, we'll be demonstrating technology-mediated pedagogical tools. The resource materials, tools, platforms, images, which are used in this presentation are used only for academic purpose under the Fair Use Clause of Copyright Act 1957 and the amendments in 1999-2012. I'm sure you all agree with me that this is the picture at all our college campuses. Generation Z are comfortable with the technologies. They are grown up in the current environment of ubiquitous mobile communications. And you know, internet has revolutionized the learning process. There is a great access to knowledge in digital form. Every learner practically has access to internet and access to such resources. Ideally speaking, therefore, it is required to maximize such quality time spent by a student on learning various topics of our subject. Therefore, there is a need of transformation. We being the teachers, we being the information provider, need to become learning facilitator. So I would like to quote the Fleming's quote here. Teaching in the internet age means we must teach tomorrow's skills today. I feel the technology-based pedagogy could help in achieving this transformation. Yeah. This slide here, I have just listed the backdrop of traditional classroom. I mean traditional, I mean here, absence of technology. A class with the number of students of size some 80 or 100 students in a class. So the problems like the voice, poor teacher's voice audibility. When teacher face the blackboard, show back to the students, maximum interaction with the chalk and duster, referring book contents becomes difficult. Visibility till the last bench is doubtful. Explaining three-dimensional object is a challenging task. So in a nutshell, the traditional classroom is a sort of teacher-centric classroom. Well, what is the result? The consequence, result, this is the result. So that means what happens in the traditional classroom or teacher-centric classroom? We teachers still lecturing. The student here feel bored, out loud, it means feeling bored with the monotonous teaching. Would like to bring to your kind notice the learning pyramid. That is learning retention rates by type of teaching. So if you observe this learning pyramid here, the retention rate of the student, so during the lecturing is 5%. Okay, reading the retention rate is 10%. Whereas if you move downwards in this pyramid, that is 50% in group discussion, 75% practice by doing, okay, 90% by teaching others. So you can observe the retention rate is less in the passive learning where the interactions are less. And as we move from passive learning to active learning, I mean participatory learning, where the more interaction, where the retention rate is more. Okay. In connecting with this slide, I would like to discuss the attention span of a student. Okay. So if you observe, this is the plot. This shows attention span of a student and effectiveness in the learning. Okay, so along the x-axis the time is shown, whereas the y-axis the effectiveness in grasping is shown. The study claims that typical students' attention span is about 10 to 15 minutes long, whereas our classes last from 60 to 90 minutes. So attention span of a student is 10 to 15 minutes, but we are having the session of time 60 to 90 minutes. Then it's natural for student attention levels to vary according to motivation, mood, perceived relevance of the material and other factors. The question raises how to keep student interested and alert for longer periods. The attention span 15 minutes, but the class size, the duration of class is 60 minutes. How to retain the student attention? Now, if you observe this plot, every 15 minutes, we being the teachers, we can change our method here. So bringing some activities, exercises in the class. So change in the method can achieve this attention span problem. So what happened? See, if I follow same method throughout 6 months, initially the frequency is good, but slowly it gradually decreases here. So at that again next 20th minute, if I change the method, so you can make out now, instead of decreasing the effectiveness of learning, the constant effectiveness can be maintained. How can we do it? Again, the ICT, use of ICT technology can help us in achieving effectiveness. The changing scenario of teaching learning. I'm talking about 21st century classroom, where it has made the learning easier, anytime, anywhere access with the help of www means internet. Okay, so anytime I can access 24/7 access to internet, so I can access the material anytime and anywhere. And the digital natives, the current generation Z students are techno savvy students, digital natives. In their language of digital natives, the collaboration can be done with the students, among the students. Learning after institution timing. The internet has made the things easy. So online courses, other platforms had made the learning after the institution timings. Mobile learning with the smartphones, GPS, data loggers. And with the help of technology here, customized learning with one-to-one support is possible. So this is the scenario of teaching learning is changing because of adapting technology and ICT-based pedagogy. To talk about 21st century learning skills, the 21st century pedagogy here focuses on high-order learning skills. Okay. I'm talking about Bloom's taxonomy, the high-order learning skills. Okay, It is encouraging collaboration with suitable technologies, effective communications, interdisciplinary approaches. The technology is supporting collaborative mediums, digital tools. The student assessment here, clear, transparent with goal objectives, self and peer assessments, the teaching using project-based learning, the 21st century pedagogy are developing information fluency, media fluency, technological fluency. Maybe we all are aware of draft new educational policy, which is built on the foundation pillars of access, equity, quality, affordability, and accountability. This policy aims at appropriately integrating technology into all levels of teaching, all levels of education. So, in connecting to this, the technology in the 21st century classroom. So, this can be a technology mediated 21st century classroom. The components here you can observe the classroom fully connected with the technology, the resource sharing through the technology, where students are accessing the resource through their devices connected with the central server. The components, if you observe, the project based learning, integrating life skills into education, online courses, learning analytics. Actually, the learning analytics here, it helps the teachers to assess top concerns and achievements related to their students. Then the integration of social networks. So integrating social networks, here I can communicate with my students, guardian, parents easily. Open source textbooks. So all these are the pedagogical components of technology mediated 21st century classroom. The top three reasons for teachers to use technology in the classroom are to adapt a diverse learning styles, boost student motivation, enhance the material being taught. Now, in connecting with the technology-based pedagogy, what social media can do, how social media changing the classroom, you can observe the six ways the social media can change your classroom. We get real sense of what the students are thinking. Okay, so if I connect the social media with my course, so depending on the communication post, we can get a sense here. And we can have easy access to in the moment of materials, so information sharing. We can connect classroom to people making a big impact, globalizing the classroom. So that is online FDP is an example. So people, the faculty members, delegates from all over India connecting with the FDP centers. So that is, we can globalize our classrooms. We can connect with the parents. Students can think about the lesson even outside the classroom. So outside the classroom, I'll talk in next two slides, that blended learning. The things to look for in our today's classroom. Okay, eight things we need to consider. I'm talking about 21st century classroom, where the students are techno-savvy students. Okay, the voice in the sense students should learn. I'm talking about peer learning, choice-based learning system, that is choice, time for reflection, opportunities and innovations, critical thinking, problem solving, self-assessment, connected learning. So all these are the things required to look for today's classroom. Now, let's talk the interactive classroom IT adoption trajectory. So now, in the beginning or long back, the classroom where the paper-based learning processes. So I can say traditional classroom, absence of technology, no classroom technology or digital content. Okay, it's a paper-based learning process. And then slowly we moved to sporadic teaching process access, where the LMS or admin tools, one PC or device in the classroom. Classroom, all institute or the classroom having very limited ICT infrastructure. Then student, where in the teacher access, only admins are having the access. So then moved to student access. So where the computer labs, digital content, interactive tools for the students. Then moved to teacher-centric system, where teachers use technology like the desktops, whiteboards, smart classroom facilities, LMS systems. And now we are in the era of interactive classroom. So earlier, just before this, it was teacher-centric. Now it is purely student-centric, where all the students have access to their devices, digital content, software. So that is the purely smart classroom. Now, how can we inculcate the technology inculcation in the teaching learning? So some of the tools I'm mentioning, and I will demonstrate them. So we need to create the content, the internet-based content that is called as e-content. Here we use Google Apps for creating the contents. Okay. The contents which we have created, we need to host it. Okay. So there, the hosting services like Dropbox is used. Then mobile apps for student engagement, interactions, instant updates. So what happens because of the online examination, the immediate result can be communicated with student immediately. Integration of student media as sharing and discussion portal, where the discussion on a topic can be done. Blogging the classroom for collaboration purpose. Content creation and redistribution using wikis. YouTube channels to cross the boundaries of the classroom. MOOCs and online learning. LMS, learning management system, like Moodle, as digital classrooms. So these are all various technology-based pedagogical tools. So these tools we can inculcate in our teaching learning process. Now, the blended learning. So maybe all of us are aware of this concept called blended learning. Here is the combination of synchronous and asynchronous mode. I mean, face-to-face learning and the supervised online activities. So you can observe in this image, the whatever the LHS side has shown, that is the live synchronous mode of content delivery. I mean, face-to-face classroom, online, live online sessions, coaching, all these are synchronous mode. Whereas asynchronous means supervised online activities, where the multimedia making use of the videos, podcasts, etc., use of blogs, wikis, web-based learning, self-paced tutorial simulations, knowledge management, workflow automation, mobile access, all these. So this the combination of live sessions and on-demand, the combination of face-to-face learning and supervised learning activities, that results in blended learning. The problem what we faced in the attention span, that can be reduced with the help of blended learning by incorporating various methods, technological based methods in the classroom. Now, in connecting with blended learning, one more concept, that is flipped classroom. Normally what we do in the class, so the content delivery takes place, that is content dissemination takes place in the class, and students solve their problem at home. Okay, that is what happening in the regular classroom. Content dissemination in the classroom and problem solving at the home. But what is the drawback of that? When the student, we assume that everything student has understood. But what happens when student tries to solve the problem? When he is facing some problem, that time the instructor or the teacher is not available there. Okay, so there he stuck. The concept of flipped classroom is that switching this, whatever happens now in the traditional classroom, it should happen in at home, and whatever happening at home, it should happen in the class. So that is the traditional classroom that needed to be flipped. Okay, so that is the class time is spent in assimilation rather than information transmission. Instead of I teaching, student understanding should happen in the class. So that, what is the advantage here? The high order cognitive levels, like, so right now it is lower order of Bloom's taxonomy, that is remembering, understanding. So this flipped classroom will help us to go at the higher level, apply, analyze, create. It supports peers and instructor is available to the student. Just a second. Yeah. So now, whatever the things technology supported, technology mediated teaching learning, what we discuss now, let us see some of the tools. How can we bring these tools? How can we bring the technology in our classroom? Okay. I would like to now the active learning, the technology mediated teaching here supports active learning, where it helps the instructor creating designed activities. See, as I said in the As I mentioned in the blended learning, the combination of face-to-face learning and supervised online activities. Okay, so we the teachers, we need to design the supervised online activities. Okay, then here it requires the students to talk, write, reflect, express their thinking. We need to engage students in problem solving activities. We need to make the students to express their reasoning explicitly. And the peer learning is playing major role. Students work collaboratively, learn the things. So what it takes to teach with the technology? So how to proceed? How can I bring technology in my classroom? The steps here, not strictly what I understood, I have planned the listed down the steps here. Planning for learning in the mix of physical, digital and social learning spaces. So we are talking about blended learning, where the combination of live, that is synchronous as well as asynchronous activities. So we are required to plan, then curating and adapting the existing content resources. So what should be talked, what should be explained in the online live session, and what additional resources must be shared in the asynchronous mode. Designing such activities, resources for active learning, where the personalized and adaptive teaching that improves the traditional method of teaching, it provides flexibility in blended learning options. We need to guide, nurture the large cohort of these students. What happens in the case of online course or online teaching or some of the programs, MOOCs, if I talk, the diversified, it's a diversified learning where the learner, I'm not taking the word student, I'm telling learner, the learner may learners may not be of same age category. Say, let me consider learning the language Python. The students, the postgraduate student also may learn for this particular course, or the person who is working in IT sector also doing this particular course. So age, the diversification in terms of age or diversification in terms of the location. So I'm talking about the design of the online course where the nurturing of large cohort, I want to mention here, diversified learners, handling the diversified learners, we need to consider that. And using learning technologies, all the technology related tools to improve the scale and outcomes. So these are the steps here, planning, curating, all these are the steps. I can make my classroom technology mediated classroom. Now, would like to mention, be the teacher should be like the conductor in an orchestra, not the trainer in the circus. So I hope you all agree with me. Okay, actually I have taken this quote from internet. The teacher's role here as a conductor, not the trainer in the circus. Now, just sharing one Google experiment with you. I will share this in the chat window. You can check it later. Okay, actually I can tell them, this is, and just to tell about this experiment, it's a AI experiment, okay, AI experiment by Google. It is a orchestra conductor experiment. Okay, if you permit me, I'll demonstrate this experiment. So means I just wanted to bring AI in my session. I will demonstrate.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
So for that, I have to share my tab. So now,
I hope I am audible now. Okay, now see, if I make some movement here, the corresponding, it is capturing AI experiment here, it is capturing the movement, and accordingly it is playing. So you can experiment it later after the session. So if you make a fast movement, see there, you can observe the devices are playing. Okay, the reason I have shared the link. Okay, I have shared the link in the chat window. You can experiment this later. Why I demonstrated this? The two reasons here. The first reason, the buzzword AI. Okay, so we can bring AI in our classroom. Lot of experiments possible with the AI. The second thing, we being the teachers, we should be conductor in the orchestra, not the trainer of the circus. One more experiment I want to show you. Okay, learning Japanese. Again, it is a AI experiment. I will share the link in chat box. So please, if you are interested, please copy and save these links. You can use them later. Okay, now this experiment, I hope it is visible. Okay, now this is a Google experiment. It helps you in, actually normally what happens, video means the continuous, we are one way, okay, there is no interaction with the video. Okay, this is the two way here, so watching the video along with the interaction, you can observe. Now learning handwriting, Japanese handwriting, this is one example. There are plenty of other examples available in Google experiments. See, I want to learn,
let's practice Japanese writing some Japanese characters
language. Okay, now
ki, which is tree in Japanese.
So I have observed. Now I can try. So we are drawing this the tree in Japanese. What I am writing, this is, yeah, this is a ki, tree in Japanese.
Onna,
like this,
which is
we can learn the language Japanese. So if you browse this particular URL, okay, you will get plenty of other examples which we can use the AI experiments for learning purpose. So the huge contribution here by Google. Now moving further. We'll demonstrate some tools which we can use in our classroom. Okay, I'll share my screen. The next one, I'm going to talk about classroom, the Google Classroom. Maybe the delegates present in the forum may be using this feature of Google. That is, it's a virtual collaboration tool for teachers and students. It's the free web service by Google. It simplifies the teaching learning process. It comprising of creation, dissemination, and grading in a paperless way. And this app here, it is combined with other Google apps. For example, the Gmail for communication, calendar for scheduling the class, the Google Sheet, Google Slide, Google Docs for content creation. Okay, now I'll just show you. See, to create a Google Classroom, to make use of this, one should have Google account. Okay. So in the app launcher, so there is a app called Google Classroom. Okay. Upon selecting this, you will get this particular screen where we have option creating the class and joining the class. Okay. So the teacher for creating the class. Now you can see these are the classes which I have created or which I am using. Okay. So I'll take you to one of the class. To create a new class, click on the create class, accept the policy document. Then, so entering all these things, that will create a new class. Okay. The Google Classroom here for content sharing, resource sharing with the students. Okay. I'll show you one of my class. This is the class on artificial intelligence. So if you observe here, classroom having four tabs. Okay. The stream, classroom features, post, the chronological post, whatever the activities we do in the class, so that gets posted or the notifications posted here in the stream under the stream tab. Classwork, the resource sharing, say we can create the assignments, quiz assignments, questions, material, and the existing post can be reused here. Okay, so just for example, I have created, these are the topics. Under the particular topic, if you observe, the resources are shared here. The resources are shared. Just a second. Then we can conduct a quiz. So where the quiz here, it uses Google form, that is Google quiz embedded with the classroom material. And again, to create, so topic wise you can arrange the contents by creating the topics. Okay, so how students join to this class? Actually, once we create a class, the class code, okay, this class code will we'll share this class code with the students. We using this class code, students can enter to this classroom, or we can send mail invitation or even the links. Okay, so people available in my present in my class, even there is a provision of co-teachers also. And whenever we do any conduct any quiz, online assignment, so posting grades are posted, that is displayed under the grade section. So this is one of the features of Google, where we can make our classroom digital classroom. All the resource sharing, online activities we can conduct with the help of digital classroom, that is Google Classroom. Okay. So in the Google Classroom, these are the various of the facilities, provisions there for teachers, and these are the various provisions for the students. So you can explore it later after the session, and you can make use of this feature for your classroom. Okay. The next, online live interaction tool, that is Mentimeter, is the online editor. Okay, where we can create interactive presentation. Okay. To get real time input from the students. Okay, we can do now. Okay, how this Mentimeter works, we can experiment now. I know afternoon session, post lunch session, so we'll have this one. Now I'll paste the link into chat window. So requesting all please go to menti.com, okay, and type the code. This is the code. There is one question. ICT based pedagogical tools. Just you have to submit, and we will construct a word cloud based on your answers. So requesting all, please go to menti.com and give this code. I hope you all are with me, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Yeah. So go to menti.com and type the code 2135393. Okay, this is the code. You do submit. You do submit. So there is a question. Name ICT tools for teaching learning process. So give some answers. What do you feel? The some of the tools which you are aware of, heard of. Just give your answer. So I will show you the word cloud. So I'll give you 30 seconds for this experiment. Yeah. You can try. Okay. Meanwhile, at the back end, so creator end, you can see here. I think you can observe your inputs. So that means, see, I have created the presentation. It's the interactive presentation, and I shared it with my students live, real life interaction here. Students are giving the answer, and their answer is displayed in the form of word cloud. So you can see now your answers. So here, whatever the answers are shown, the whatever the text is displayed in the word cloud, this is entered by the delegates present in this online forum. Yes. So you can try. Meanwhile, I'll go to next experiment. So what is Mentimeter here? Mentimeter is for online interaction, creating interactive presentation. Here I had shown you your answers in the form of word cloud. It can be the grid one or other types of responses can be displayed. You can explore it later. Okay, the next one. One more, web content, interactive web content tool, that is EXE Learning. The proprietary version of this is Adobe Captivate. I'll share the link with you. I'm sharing all the links.
Ma'am, sorry for the interruption. Ma'am, in Mentimeter, can we know who has given what answer as the thing?
Yes, madam. Yes, there are different types of presentation. I will show you. Here, you just do register. You please register here in the Mentimeter. And the free version, say for example, new presentation, create presentation. Yeah, here you have different types of presentation. The presentation which I use now is word cloud, multiple choice, open-ended, scales, ranking, QA. So various types of presentations are available. So you can explore it later. Am I answered?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay. Yeah. The next is EXE Learning. Maybe you are aware of the proprietary software for content creation, web content, interactive web content creation, that is Adobe Captivate. The open source version of this is EXE Learning. It is free and open source editor to create education resources. The complete course site can be created here. All course, your course site website can be created, and that web page you can connect it with your LMS, or you can connect it with your other sites. This is too easy to create high quality websites with web pages, including text, images, interactive activities, and it can be integrated with LMS, as I said. Okay. So the thing is that you need to download this software from this link. So you are required to download it from this link and install it in your machine. And just downloading this and install it, and then just execute it. You can see here. See, so EXE Learning here. This is the one which I have installed and I have created it. Okay. So now, just to demonstrate here, I have created the course on artificial intelligence. Okay. Where containing, so you can add interactive activities, non-interactive activities. Here it containing the four pages. Overview, then I have added the multiple choice, that is the quiz here, and the material also shared. Okay. Just for the demonstration purpose, I created this particular project. Here, after your work, you can save it as, you can export it as, see, observe, you can export it as a website or a single page or a SCOM object. So the SCOM, exporting it as a SCOM or a SCOM object, that is required to integrate it to your LMS. Okay, export it as a SCOM object and integrate it with your LMS like Moodle. So I hope you will explore it later. Okay, that is EXE Learning. It's the open source. Whatever the tools I'm discussing, all these are the open source tools for creating educational resources, creating high quality web pages, including various learning resources. Okay. The next one. Online bulletin board, okay. Padlet. Okay. Bulletin board, all of us are aware of. Now, how to create an online bulletin board? Here, the name of the tool is Padlet. I will copy the link for your reference. You can check it later. Copy both the links. This is to share content with others, like a quick bulletin boards, blogs, and portfolios. Quickly we can share. This is to create a beautiful boards, documents, web pages. And this is useful in a virtual classroom to engage the activities, interactive discussion. Okay. Creating this board and sharing with the students, ask them to give their opinion, ask them to give their answers there. So a sort of interactive discussion is possible with the help of the tool called Padlet. Okay. So the links I will share in the chat box. Okay, no problem. Some message from Mr. Nair that some issue at Kerala. No problem, sir. No problem. Okay. I have shared two links. You can explore them later. Okay. The Padlet.com here. By using Padlet, how we can create online bulletin board. I'll show you. This is the bulletin board which I have created for the testing purpose. Here, this is actually, this is the Padlet.com. The first thing, if you want to use it, you have to register. From your account, you create a Padlet. So these are the Padlets available in my account. So you make a Padlet, create it, select the theme and other things, and then it can be shared with the URL. The code or the URL can be shared with the students so that, now see, this is the URL I'll share with my students, or you can check from your end. So open this URL and just click on the plus, this button, so that you can give your opinion. So the question here, the question raised by me is, give brief opinion on technology mediated teaching learning. Okay, actually these are the responses which I collected in the previous workshop. Okay, now if you want to participate in this activity, open this URL, click on the pen button here, and whatever the response you enter, that will get displayed in my Padlet. You can check it later also, no problem. Okay, so thus the Padlet is the online bulletin board. Okay, yeah, I'm getting answers here. This is an someone is typing. I can see here, this is important for present scenario to sustain, can increase. See, live. So the responses displaying here. This is, we can make use of this feature, this tool for online interaction with our students. So that is Padlet. For, it is an online bulletin board. Okay, now to talk about mentor web presence. So maybe you heard of WordPress, the content management system for creating web pages, web portal, websites. This is a simple website for teaching and research faculty. Here we can create mentor web presence. I mean, all the course related, not only course related information, the teacher wants to share the information with the student, contents, all these things can be shared in the form of website. Okay, so the web portal, it can be of in the name of teacher, or it can be course portfolio only for particular course. Say for example, ICT pedagogy is the course. So related to ICT pedagogy, I'm creating the web portal. All the content sharing, communication through that portal takes place. So here, for that, to create a portal, we can make use of CMS, content management system like WordPress. Okay, this is for making the resource available online. Here, when I say creating website, the coding, non-IT person may think, I don't know coding, how can I create a web page? So your coding, the HTML or other things not required. CMS, content management system, is without writing code, only managing with the content, you can create your own web page, your own web portal. No need to have any knowledge about programming here. Okay, we can create a blog, where we can post the teaching materials, the teacher teaching portfolios or the course portfolios can be created with the help of WordPress. Okay, so I will share the link with you. I will show you the sample. You can explore this site, that is wordpress.com. Again, you need to register here first, and after the registration, creating the site. Now, I'll show you the web portal which I have created, okay, using WordPress. Okay, all the information. Actually, this the free version here, it comes with the WordPress in your URL. The paid one, there will not be wordpress.com. You can select your own domain. Okay, so here, as I said, the coding knowledge is not required. Okay, so no need to, without having HTML or CSS knowledge, you can design your own web page. Okay, only uploading the content, creating this site, okay, then uploading the content, say for example the page. So whatever shown here, these are all the pages. Here uploading the content, that is called as content management system. Okay, so that is for Mentor's web presence, the simple way of creating website for teaching and research faculties, and it can be your teaching portfolio or it can be your course portfolio. Okay, so next, one more useful open source learning tool, that is Genomeo. Okay, this is to create website for your course. Okay, most of you are maybe aware of Moodle. Moodle here is the intranet based, but if you want the internet version, there is one more that is called as Moodle Cloud, and this one also you can use Genomeo. This is the you can create site for your course where all type of activities what we do in the regular classroom, that is the video, we can share the presentations, we can share all the contents, video sharing, conducting the quiz, so everything we can do with the help of this LMS. How to create it? I'll share the link with you. I will share it in the chat box. Due to time constraint, I'm demonstrating. I will share it in the classroom. Thank you, Shreya. Yeah, sure. We'll share. Thank you. Yeah. Now, what's Genomeo? I will show you both the things. See, I'll show you my site first. This is areskamath.genomeo.com. So here in this, this is my Moodle, where is the internet, okay, not the intranet base, where I have my courses here. These are the courses. Under the course, okay, actually I logged in session out here. I'll log in again. Okay, so under this course, the topic wise I can arrange the content. Then I'll site administration. The whole, this is my site now. Okay, now I can admit the student, I can create various, see, you can observe here. So users, courses, grades, all these settings we can change. So now how to create the Moodle site for ourselves or a particular course. So go to genomeo.com. Here again, it is free. Okay, all the tools which I am discussed today are open source versions. Okay, now you select the site name. See, when I creating, I have selected this particular URL, I mean this domain name. You can give the required site name, your email address, and can continue create site. if that domain name which you have selected, if already others have not used, then you can continue. Otherwise, it asks you to change the title, the name of the domain. In this way, we can create the open source learning tool, that is virtual classroom, virtual classroom for our courses. Okay, so the next one. So lot of things I shared related to the content sharing, web mentor, web presence. Now let me talk something related to assessment. Okay, while explaining Google Apps, Google Classroom, I discussed the quiz. Okay, we are making use of Google Quiz, that is Google Form, for the assessment purpose. The one more very useful app, that is, so someone answered at the time of mentee interaction. Okay, I think I have closed that. Okay, I think I have closed it. Mentee interaction, somebody has answered that Kahoot. That's what I'm going to discuss now. Yeah, so Padlet, coming back to my Padlet, so I can see some of the answers. Okay, see the Dr. Anushree Malik, the answer given by Dr. Anushree is displayed here. This type of Padlet we can create to interact with the students. Okay, so let me go to Kahoot now. Okay, this is the game-based learning platform that brings engagement and fun. The educational technology in schools and other institutions where the MCQs, quizzes can be accessed to web browsers or the apps here. Okay, now again the thing, all these tools which I mentioned, to use them you need to register first. Using your login credentials you can access them. Okay, here so you need to register first to Kahoot. Okay, here then creating your Kahoot, that means you can create your quiz. Okay, what type, so some templates you can create a quiz where you can add your questions, what type of questions, true and false questions or the MCQs, like this you can give. Okay, so then, so these are the Kahoots which are there in my account. Okay, so just to share with the students, click on the play. So then the pin, okay, that pin will be shared, that pin is shared with the students. So live live responses you can receive from the students and immediate grading. So this really, even we are using here, students enjoying this type of activity in the classroom. We can bring this activity in our classroom, not only in the online classes. Okay. Normally what we do in the classroom, the topic-based discussion takes place. Okay, such discussion, online discussion is possible with the help of tool called Flipgrid. Okay, that is, this is a very simple way to foster short video-based discussion on classroom topics. What we do in the class, we give some topic, say it may be the debate or the discussion, okay, and we ask students to give their opinions. The same activity can be done online also. Sharing the topic, asking the students to give their opinion in the form of video. It's a video-based discussion, short video-based discussion on the topic. How to create this? So the steps, mainly creating the grid. Again, it's very easy. I will share the link with you. Okay, creating the grid. Then adding the topic, on which topic, say for example, I want to know your opinion about ICT-based pedagogy, or your opinion, your feedback about our program, that is faculty development program related to higher education. Okay, I create a grid and I add the topic. So feedback about this FDP, and I share that the code or the pin is required here. That means that is shared with you all. Where once you receive that URL, there is a button. Upon clicking that, you can send your voice, your video of 30 seconds or 1 minute. Okay, what I said, I will show you. We have experimented it. I will share it in the thank you very much for your feedbacks. Yeah. You can check it later. I will just show you what we have done in our classroom during the lockdown. This is you just register here. The first URL which I have shared, no, that is if see. Actually, during lockdown, we have conducted one program, placement orientation program for our students, where at the end of the program, the students' feedback we have collected in the form of video-based discussion. What we done, we created the grid using Flipgrid. It's very easy. So only the thing, you register here, and after the registration, you have to select create. Okay, there is a button called create, and you add the topic. Add the topic, and the share button is there. That is to share with your students. What we have done, we shared this link with the students, and students, they shared their feedback in the form of video. See, now these are the feedbacks received from the students. Okay, just see students' feedback in the form of 1 minute video here. Actually, how students have recorded, very easy. This URL is shared with the student. Upon clicking the button, the recording, the capturing that starts, and the student has recorded their video. See, now students' video is like this. So this is the simple way to experiment or the video based discussion on classroom topics. So the debate or the discussion what we do in the classroom, the same thing can be simulated in the online class also. So you can explore it, flipgrid.com. okay, I have shared this URL also. You can I think I have shared in the chat. Yeah, I have shared it. So what you do, you open this URL after the session. Open this URL, okay, and just click on this button, okay, and you give your feedback, your opinion, and that will get displayed in this particular page. You can experiment it. Yes. The next, to create I wanted to talk about open educational resources. Okay, most important here. The digitized material offered, OER, maybe you are aware of open educational resources, that is digitized material offered freely and openly for all the educators, students, and self-learners to use and reuse for teaching learning. So this is called as, when can I say my material is OER? When the material is licensed, having CC license, then I can say this is OER. Okay. The resource, whichever I created, having CC license, Creative Commons license, okay, is called as open educational resource. How to add this license?
easy. I'll take two more minutes. I'll just show you. See, you might have observed now, this is the slide here. To this slide, I have added Creative Commons attribution. This license is added. So what is the meaning of CC attribution 4.0? Anybody having access to this slide can use it for commercial purpose with modification also can be used. Okay. All the details available in this URL. So whenever you want to create your OER, okay. So to tell, this is my OER here. Okay. Just I will post it in the. Thank you all for your feedback. Yeah. See, go to this. I have shared it in the chat window. Okay. So go to this URL. Here there is option called share your work. Okay. In the share your work, you have to select the license, get started. There you have to select which type of license you want. The selected here, see whether you want your work to be shared. Yes, I want. Allow commercial use. So whether you are allowing for commercial use or not. Okay. So you select it and then just you have to copy this. See this particular thing. You have to copy and the material which you want to make it as a OER, there you have to share. If I want to make my web page OER, then this code I have to copy and I have to paste it to my web page. So here the attribution, all these things you can explore it later. Okay. One more URL I want to share that is related to TED-ED. Okay. TED Talks all are aware of, okay. So this is the feature TED-ED, TED educational version, that is, I'll share it with you, URL. Explore it later. You can create your TED lessons. You can create your TED lessons here. So, taking YouTube videos or your own videos, see how to create TED lesson. TED-ED, here go to lesson. So, you need to register. As I said, all the tools requires registration. You select some YouTube URL or your own video and you can attach the additional, say the quiz resources. Adding to that video, you can prepare your TED lesson. Okay, I will show you the one which I have created for this demonstration. Okay. I have created the lesson, TED lesson on AI. Where I added the YouTube video, it is my own video, where the quiz is added to this particular lesson. You can add the title, you can explore it, the think related activities, the deep digger activities. So you can add all these activities to your video and that can be your TED lesson. And how can you share it? You publish it. And this URL, you share it with your student so that students can access this TED lesson. So the objective here, objective of this presentation or this session, how can we make teacher-centric learning or to learner-centric? That is learner-centric. So with the help of, so in the first presentation, in the first slide, we discussed attention span of the student.
So the attention span, with the help of the adding different methods, the effectiveness can be achieved. Thus, technology helps in learning retention. So this is the what the Generation Z expects from us. This is done. Yes. So if any question, doubt, please unmute and ask. I'll try to answer.
Yes, the session is now open for question answer.
Very informative session was there, ma'am.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Many information we get from this. What are different techniques, ICT tools that are there for the teaching and learning processes? And most of the techniques are new for us also, ma'am. So it's very informative to us.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, Marcia, for such a nice presentation.
Yeah. It's my pleasure. Thank you. Actually, lockdown has taught us many things.
What, ma'am?
Lockdown, during this pandemic, no, we learned a lot many things.
Yes, yes, yes.
Yeah. So, yeah, I'm seeing your feedback which you have shared in the chat window. Yes, thank you very much for your feedback. Any questions, you can unmute and ask. Yes, we'll share the PPT, the resources. I'll share it with the Dr. Kale sir. The sir will share it with you after the FDP. Yes, sir. Thank you. Thank you.
Yes, all the recorded sessions will be uploaded on Apple FDP. So all will be sent to Apple FDP from where you can download. And our coordinator also will be sharing, the coordinator, Dr. Kale sir, will be also sharing the recording as well as the resource person presentations to all the participants. Ma'am, the question, are these platforms paid platforms or whether they are free?
No. All the tools which I discuss, platforms, all of them are open source. Only for the higher features, there may be some paid versions. But for the academic purpose, whatever the open source features, the freely available features are enough. Can you yes. Yeah, I'll share my mail ID.
There is one more question from Sushma Chawla. That is, most of the students are attending classes on their mobile phone. So will these tools work on the mobile phones?
Yeah, most of the students use mobile for attending the class. So will all these tools? Yes. Now the concept of mobile responsive. Okay, all the web pages, websites, web portals are having the feature mobile responsive. So all the tools which I discussed having mobile version. Say for example, you consider Kahoot. So mobile app is there. Some you can use it through your browsers, and some apps are available. So Genomio, say for example, WordPress, you can directly use it through your browser. Chrome you can use. I'm telling from the mobile point of view. Or if you consider Kahoot, the mobile app is available. I have shared my mail ID. You can explore these tools. If you find any difficulty, please ping me. I try to answer.
So if there are no more questions, we will go to the concluding this session. Okay, it's my pleasure to propose the vote of thanks for this session. On behalf of Cyber and Atal FDP organizing team, I extend a very hearty vote of thanks to our resource person and expert of this session, Dr. Rajni Kamath ma'am, for her very informative, interesting and interactive session on role of ICT and use of technology in teaching learning. Ma'am has focused on the required 21st century skills in the classroom, focusing on technology mediated teaching learning. Ma'am has also shared very useful teaching tools as well as e-content creation tools, which will make teaching interactive as well as which will have an increasing impact on learning outcomes. So definitely for all the participants, there were many good takeaways from this session, and I think all the participants will definitely explore the tools that you have shared with us, ma'am. So once again, I thank you, ma'am, for such a wonderful session. Yes, and at the same time, I thank all the participants for joining in for this session and request you all for to join tomorrow's session, morning session at 10:15. The session will be starting exactly sharp at 10:30. So till then, from Cyber and from the organizing committee of this FDP, a very good evening to all of you.